we created a website clearinghouse for stained glass that all denominations are welcome to participate in. And what we do is we will go in and document the stained glass windows with very high quality photography, like high definition photography, with bracketing the photos and measuring them very carefully and listing them and posting it all on a website called the Sacred Window Rescue Project. And people don't pay, they don't rent time on this or anything. The only thing anybody ever has to pay for is like the effort to get it up there, the photography and documentation, mm-hmm. that sort of thing. So we have this clearinghouse, and churches from all over the country then can view these windows with their architects and ideally build new churches around these windows. So it's a great way to rescue windows from churches in neighborhoods where they're redundant, the buildings are closed, and windows can't last forever. Simply leaving 100-year-old windows in place is not an option.
Had anybody ever done that before, created a clearinghouse, kind of a central place where you can go and see what's
happening? No.
Because it's a specialized field. It's a pretty niche field. It's right. Not like you would naturally know where to go to find historic 100-year-old
where
windows.
Where do you go? And the problem is that there are antique dealers out there who are getting their hands on windows and representing windows like this. But the problem is they don't have the expertise to do the restoration work. And it's really important for churches to understand what they're getting into when a committee gets involved with old windows. It's harder if you have an old building. It's much easier if you're starting from scratch and you can literally build the church around the windows. I always say that we're the tail that wags the dog. And that's kind of what happened here. We start out with very careful consensus of dimensions about these windows coming here to the new cathedral. We measure them very carefully. Then we share that information with a frame maker in Jamaica, New York, digitally, all using the same CAD software that Jim O'Brien uses.
And Jim O'Brien being our architect.
Indeed,
for the
cathedral. Yes. So that frame maker will then engineer the window frame around them, making sure there's enough strength there for wind loading, et cetera. Then he will share all that information with the architect, and back to us, we'll confirm it and say, yes, we're on board with all these dimensions. This works well. And then Jim will engineer the dimensions of the hole in the wall to accept the stained glass windows and their frames. So it's the opposite. Usually somebody makes a hole in the wall and they invite someone like me to fill it, but instead we're driving it from the opposite direction.